morning, students. We are talking about common name system, and in common name system, we have completed the common name for alcohols. Now, in today's lecture, we will complete the common name for aldehyde, the common name for ketone, and the common name for carboxylic acid. So let us start with the second group, that is aldehyde. Now, before we start, you have to remember some terms that will be used for the common name of aldehydes. And the terms or words are: if aldehyde contains one carbon atom, then we will be using term form. If we have two carbon atom, then we will use term acid. And if we have three carbon atom, then we will use term propion. Be careful, here it is propion. And if we have four carbon atom, then we will use term butyl. And if we have five carbon atom, then we will use term valine. So if you remember this term for the number of carbon atoms, then you can very easily assign common name to the given aldehyde. What you have to do? Just use this term plus aldehyde. It will give you the common name for the aldehyde. Like the first member, that is HCH2. It is having one carbon atom, so term here used will be form. Because we are talking about aldehyde, so aldehyde will be added to form, and the common name for the first member will be formaldehyde. Similarly, CH3CHO, it is having two carbon atom, so we have to use term acid. Acid plus aldehyde gives you acetaldehyde as the common name for the second member. Similarly, third member, CH3CH2CHO, it will be propionaldehyde. For fourth member, CH3CH2CH2CHO, you know it very well that with four carbon atom, branching is possible. It can be straight chain or it can be a branch structure. So here, since the structure is straight, there is no branching present, so here we have to use term normal also. So CH3CH2CH2CHO, the common name for the fourth member will be normal butyraldehyde, or just create a branch chain, just have CH3 here on the second last carbon atom. You know it very well that this unit is called iso unit. So compound name is isobutyraldehyde. Similarly, for the next member, it will be normal valeraldehyde, or it can be isovaleraldehyde. Now, let us move to the third functional group, that is ketone, having general representation as R C double bond O R. Now, how to name the organic compound having ketone group as the functional group according to common name system? So this R part will be treated as alkyne. This R part will be treated as alkyne, and C double bond O group is termed as ketone. So if R and R group are dissimilar, if they are different, then the common name for ketone will be alkyl-alkyl ketone. And here, we will be following alphabetical order. Like, if one group is ethyl, other group is methyl. E of ethyl comes before M of methyl. So, ethyl term will be named first. And if both the R groups are same, the R groups provided are similar,
then the ketones are named as dialkyl ketone. For example, the simplest member having three carbon atom, CH3, C double bond to CH3. As both the R groups are same, here the R groups are methyl, so this compound is named as dimethyl ketone. Methyl and methyl, methyl repeated two times, so it becomes dimethyl, and for C double bond group we will be using ketone here. So its common name is dimethyl ketone, or it is also called acetone, the nail polish remover, thinner. Now the next member, CH3, C double bond to CH2, CH3. One side we are having methyl group, other side we are having ethyl group. So it will be named as alkyl ketone. As E comes before M, so compound will be named as ethyl methyl ketone. Not methyl ethyl ketone. It will be ethyl methyl ketone. We have to follow alphabetical order. CH3, CH2, C double bond to CH2, CH3. Both sides, we are having same alkyl group, and here the alkyl group present our ethyl group. So this compound will be named as diethyl ketone. Similarly, you can use the rule that I have told you, when to use normal, when to use iso, etc., etc. So it is about the common name of ketone. Now, let us move to the common name for carboxylic acid. It is one symbol. If you remember the rules that we have used in aldehyde, then you can very easily name the carboxylic acid according to common name system. What you have to do? You have to simply replace aldehyde by ic acid. Ic acid for the carboxylic acid. So the terms used will remain same. For C equals to 1, we will be using form. For C equals to 2, we will be using acid. For 3, propion. For 4, bute. And for 5, it will be valer. So with the given terms, you have to add ic acid. So let us talk about the simplest member, that is HCOH. For one carbon, we are using term form. Which form we have to use ic acid? So compound name will be formic acid. You know its source. Formica. Formicus. This stands for red ants. It is secreted by red ants. So compound name is formic acid. Similarly, CH3COH. For two carbon atom, we are using term acid. Add ic acid with the acid, it will be acetic acid. Then third member, CH3CH2COH, it will be propionic acid. And then the next member, CH3CH2CH2COH. This acid is present in butter. The source is butter. So compound is butyric acid. Since as we are having four carbon atom, branching is possible, but here there is no branching, it's a straight chain. So it will be named as normal butyric acid. Just create a branching. Let us have an iso group here. It becomes isobutyric acid. Remember, if the second last carbon atom is having two methyl group, then this unit is called iso unit. So compound is isobutyric acid. Now increase the number of carbon atom. Let us make it 5. For 5 we are using valer. So here CH3, CH2, 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 COH. A straight chain with 5 carbon and a carboxylic acid group. So compound will be named as normal valeric acid. In this manner, we have to assign common name to aldehyde, ketone, and carboxylic acid. Thank you.